Hey there, cousin here, and welcome back to Always Doing. You may remember a few months ago I did a video series I would like to binge, and those were all series that I can see myself blowing through in a very short amount of time. Today's video is similar, but also very, very different. It's series I would like to get back to. I'm very good at starting series, but not so good at finishing them, so I have 14 to talk to you about today. I will be showing you book one up here, and I will be linking to the series page on Goodreads down below. First is the Mary Russell series by Laurie R. King. It's also the first of several historical mystery series on this list. Mary Russell quite literally stumbles over a retired Sherlock Holmes one day, and as they talk, they realize that they have a very similar mind, like way of thinking, and they end up working together to solve some mysteries. And that's what this series follows, all those mysteries, as well as how their relationship evolves and other things. The mysteries are great, the characters are nuanced and interesting, and I think most of all though, I love the writing. King does such a great job evoking the period, as well as just having these beautiful turns of phrase and these beautiful insights that I end up highlighting as I go. I've read the first three books, so the next one I have is number four, and there are currently 16 of them. The most recent was released in June. The Dayavabad trilogy by S.A. Chakraborty is desert fantasy, and the trilogy was recently completed. Book three came out not all that long ago, Empire of Gold, and I have read City of Brass, and I really liked it. It was a book that I kept on reading, not in spite of myself, but I was thinking, what else could I possibly need from a book? Here I have adventure, there's a bit of a love story, there's political intrigue, there's action. There was never a reason for me to pick up another book. In the first book, we meet a woman who is very good at parting people from their money, various shyster type kinds of things going on, but she inadvertently summons a djinn, and things go way off from there. I am excited to get back to this series. At the same time, I'm also hesitant because I read City of Brass a long time ago, and I don't remember all that much, especially the political machinations and the details. So from what I understand, book two doesn't follow on directly. I should be able to just read it and be okay, but confidence, I don't have it. I've read the first book of the Julia Gray series by Diana Rayborn, and this is another historical mystery series, and it wasn't perfect, but it was just what I needed at the time, and I remember because I was reading it during a typhoon, and the wind was blowing and the rain was crashing, and I needed something to take my mind off that, and this book was a perfect combination of history, so a different place, a different time, as well as humor, and just the mystery kept me involved. So even though it wasn't the best book ever, necessarily, it was just what I needed and it'd be a great series to go back to. There are five books. The last one came out in 2011, so I'm going to assume that there's just the five, and like I said, I've only read the first one. This next series is my one cheat. It's the Women Who Dare series by Beverly Jenkins. It's my cheat because there's only one book out right now, Rebel, and I haven't read it yet, but I really want to get to it because the next book, Wild Rain, and can we just have a look at this cover? I am so interested in what's going to be going on here. This comes out, I believe, in February 2021, so I would really like to read Rebel before that comes out, just so I can stay up to date on Jenkins' historical works. I didn't realize when I ordered these there would be so many where I've only read book one, but next is the Books of Ombra series by Tasha Suri. I've read the first book on recommendation of Jocelyn over at Yogi with a Book. Love it. Desert fantasy, engrossing. Part of a, right now it's a duology. I believe this series is going to be all companion novels. And there's one other one that I need to pick up, especially because the author is starting another series before too long from now. So yeah, this is another one that'd be nice to get to it sooner rather than later. You may have heard of the Murderbot Diaries by Martha Wells. It's a pretty well-loved series here on BookTube. Murderbot is a mostly robot that is socially anxious and has hacked its own governor module. So it's supposed to be told what to do, but it has a mind of its own and it goes off and does things in all these different places, kind of gets attached to humans, kind of doesn't. And I've read the first two. That's good. I've read the first two of this one. And there's two more novellas as well as a full-length novel. And when I was reading those first two, I felt like I was catching up to where it was, so I laid off it for a while, and I never got back on it. So I need to do that. I've been saying I need to do that a lot. I don't need to. It'd be nice to. I should change. It'd be nice to. One of my favorite historical romance authors of all time is Lorraine Heath, but you wouldn't know that from watching this channel because I don't think I've read a single book of hers since I started making videos, and we're coming up on 2 years. It's been a while, so I'd like to get back. The series that I was in the middle of was The Scoundrels of St. James. These tend to be, I forgot if it's exactly Regency or Edwardian or Georgian romance series in England, but what I love about her books are the inner conflicts are really well done, and her writing style, it makes it really easy to slip into the time period, to be taken away to the other world. Escapism is totally my thing. Would love to get back to this. I'm happy to say that I only have one book left in the Ravenel series by Lisa Kleypas, and that there don't appear to be any more. I don't think. Let's not jinx it. But this series started in 2015. I have kept up with it, reading each new book pretty much as it comes out. There have been a couple of duds, but a lot of really great ones, including Hello Stranger, which is a book that I can very easily recommend if you're thinking about getting into historical romance. It's got action, and you can hardly go wrong with Lisa Kleypas. And I'm curious to see what she'll be doing after this series because she does write contemporary and stuff as well, but I'm only really into her historicals. Next, we have the Lord Peter Wimsey series by Dorothy L. Sayers, and I highly recommend these. The audiobook's done by Ian Carmichael. I don't think he did the first one, and I'm not sure if he did all the later ones, sadly, but there's a bunch. I read number 2 by him, and I think number 3 was also his narration, and they were great. There's a little bit of weird stuff going on in this series because it's a historical mystery series. It takes place between the wars in England, and I love the characters. I love them. The mysteries most of the time are really interesting, but if you look at the order on Goodreads, there's like a group of short stories kind of plopped in near the beginning here, but I have it on good authority that they're highly skippable. So I don't, all I know is the next one I have, I believe, is number 4, The Unpleasantness at the Belladonna Club, I believe. But yeah, I'm skipping those short stories, don't really need it. And everyone says there's a book, as soon as Harriet Vane comes in, it gets so much better, and I still love it as it is. So anyway, another one to get back to. During Queer Lit Readathon this year, I read the first book in the Spies Who Loved Her series by Katrina Jackson, and I really liked it. It's an erotic spy thriller that has polyamory and all kinds of queerness and fun. The plot works. It's not meant to be taken too incredibly seriously, at least that's the vibe I get. At the same time, the character work is really well done. It's sexy, it's fun, and I'm really interested to see what happens in the next book and where things go on from here. I believe there are 5 books right now, and I don't think it's finished yet. I would be remiss if I didn't talk about the Fruits Basket series by Taoki Yanatsuki. Slowly going through this one for fun in Japanese, and I am currently reading volume number 5. There's 23, as well as a whole bunch of anime. And I'm reading the manga volumes and then watching the associated anime episodes, but I'm like really far behind. So, and this one I can kind of study in a really odd way. I'm like, oh, this is Japanese input. A little less guilt. We're getting there, only 3 series left. Next is the Beards and Bondage series by Rebecca Weatherspoon. It features BDSM, it's romantic suspense, and bearded kind of mountain men type heroes, very, I don't say rustic, but you know. Strong guys who can take care of themselves and, of course, the people they love. The third one just came out, and even though I don't usually read romantic suspense, Weatherspoon is one of those authors that I will like cross genre lines for, and she has made it utterly worth it, even though some of it freaks me out a little bit. But this most recent book is MMF, which is something we haven't seen in the previous two, and I'm excited to try it out. And all the covers are great, it just looks great. Then there's the Jek Saga series by H.E. Trent, which is a pen name for Holly Trent, and this is science fictional romance that I'm really enjoying for. Now, the romance isn't the biggest selling point for me, to be perfectly honest. It's the overarching story about humans that have gone into space to colonize a planet because they're like, oh, they're all the aliens there need our help and we're going to colonize them. It's for their own good, when of course it's not. And over time, we're watching the native peoples like take their planet back and how they're fighting against all of these awful systems that the humans put in place. And there's a lot of higher level discussion here. The romances themselves, the first one I liked, the second one, iffy, the third one, I had major problems, and I think that's why I haven't been so interested to get back into it just now. Book four. Book five has a hero that I'm really looking forward to. But yeah, I'm sure that once I get back into it, it'll be fine. I just have to get there. And last, we have the Mercy Thompson series by Patricia Briggs. This is urban fantasy where we have Mercy Thompson on the cover. She is a shapeshifter. She turns into a coyote. And so in these books, we have fae, we have vampires, we have different kinds of shapeshifters. We have all of these things come together and her relationships with them all. There's usually some kind of big bad in each book that needs to be taken care of. Very just urban fantasy, but it's so well done. The characters are so well thought out. And when I first started reading this series, I very consciously spread them out, where I would only read one every other month because going back to them feels like revisiting friends, and I love that. I got through book six, and then I had trouble getting my hands on the next book for a decent price. But I've got book seven now, and yeah, I think I just got used to not reading it, which is sad. There's something like 12 maybe books now. So that's another one that would be nice to get back to. That's the whole point of the video. I feel like I've been saying a lot, but it's the whole point of the video. So there we have it, a whole bunch of series that I've been meaning to get back to. And I'm curious, are you the kind of person that blows through series in one go? Do you like spreading them out? Are you like me and put them aside with every intention to get back to them and then forget to get back to them? Let me know down below. And also let me know if you love any of these series and think I should get back to it sooner rather than later. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.